Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Nancy Cole, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dulafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reimer.
Johnny-o. Look at that. Nice of you to join us here. Let's take a look at the assorted ding-a-lings we have here. Oh, I love that combination of red and blue. That's beautiful.
Hail, Pennsylvania.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's her home state, isn't it?
Yes.
Anything, anyone has anything to say?
I have a complaint to register.
What is that?
I have two broken knees because for some odd reason they put two poles here.
Really?
So every time I turn my little bod to talk to Charles, I crack this knee. When I turn back, I crack this knee.
Okay, that's... you guys, get out of there.
That's why we put them there.
Oh! Now I get it.
All right, let's say hello to our two players, Paula Miller and Susan McIntosh. Hello, champ. Current champ here. It's your total of $5,950. And she's being challenged by Susan McIntosh, who did better than average, I think, for her first rounder. Three is not bad. You know, the first round ones are tough, aren't they?
Yes.
You play the game at home?
When I get a chance.
Oh, really? Oh, with all those kids and all that.
No. It's that I work during the day, so I only get to watch
at
night.
Well, that's right. You're an accountant, aren't you?
Right.
How much are 2 and 2?
7.
Gotta, girl. Hire that girl. Okay. Now, we're going to finish this game, hope to finish it today. We're in the middle of round one, but first we've got to do a little business, then we'll come right back to you. Hurry back. Ready. Ready, ready, ready. Bing. There it is, the other round one question, Paula. This one's all yours. Here it is. Harvey said, my wife is such a rotten cook that in the middle of our dinner table, instead of a centerpiece, we have a blank. My wife is such a rotten cook. In the middle of our dinner table, instead of a centerpiece, we have a blank.
I got it.
Okay.
Hi.
A little juice?
A little grapefruit juice. Make it big and strong.
Isn't that nice?
Very good.
Ah, tart.
Okay.
What did you call? Dancing as fast as I can.
You called me a tart.
No. It's very tart drink there.
Oh.
Puckers your mouth there. Paulie, ready? We're not ready. Yes, we are. Harvey said, my wife is such a rotten cook in the middle of our dinner table. Instead of a centerpiece, we have a...
A waste paper basket.
A waste paper basket.
Garbage can.
Garbage can, waste paper basket. It's all the same thing, isn't it? Something like that. What do you say, Avery?
I say...
Avery the Shribe.
Yeah. She had a spittoon.
A spittoon.
Expectorate in.
Well, to expectorate in, yeah.
Very funny.
Yeah. What do you say?
Well, I tried to be just a bit more genteel and give a little class.
A little
to
classy,
this show.
Right. You are a classy
I
dame.
I said a small but elegant garbage pail.
Well, that'll do it. There's one. What do you offer, sir?
Small and elegant is the words I couldn't use. I just said, Gina, garbage pail.
A garbage pail. That's Cupid, Paula. In the middle of our dinner table, instead of a centerpiece, we have a garbage pail.
I believe in calling a can a can.
Really?
Garbage can.
Oh, a can, yeah.
Woo-hoo!
That's not what I call a can, is
it? It
is. What do you say?
Garbage disposal.
Garbage disposal. Now, wait a minute. A disposal.
They were more modern.
Run by an electric motor and has not a garbage can. What do you say?
I'm more old fashioned, but I didn't know how to spell it. I said a spittoon.
F-A-S-A-S-A-S-A. A spittoon.
Will you marry me?
So, here we are. At the end of round one, we have a tie score, 3-3. Round two coming up, and Susan, you may have A or B.
B again.
B again? All right. Howard Cosell bought a gun and tried to kill himself. It wasn't fatal. He only shot his blank off. You don't play because you matched last time. Howard Cosell bought a gun and tried to kill himself. It wasn't fatal. He only shot his blank off.
You don't write.
And Avery does, and he did.
And he do.
Okay.
No, you don't get to write.
Howard Cosell bought a gun and tried to kill himself, but it wasn't fatal. He only shot his blank off.
Mouth.
Atta girl, Susan. Smart kid, right, Avery? Now, you don't play, but you do play, Richard.
Howard Cosell in his mouth.
That's it. Time for her. Now comes the hard part. Or now comes the bad news. Hello, Joyce.
Oh, hi. Mouth, huh? Doesn't he wear a thing on that?
Yes, he does.
Well, if he was going to shoot his head, he'd miss and hit his wig.
Shot his wig off. Okay, so that's five for her. Now let's see how you do with yours. You've got to match two to tie and three to win. Dumb Dora, so dumb. Thank you. I'll tell you how dumb she is. When her husband told her they were going to take a plunge in the stock market, Dumb Dora bought a blank. Avery plays. You don't play. Bing, bing. All right.
Very nice indeed.
Hello, Paula. Dumb Dora, so dumb, Paula. When her husband told her they're going to take a plunge in the stock market, Dumb Dora bought a blank.
A bathing suit.
Bathing suit it is. Girl wants a bathing suit.
No, I didn't think she bought an island, but the bikini.
Bikini. That's a bathing suit. Score is now 5-4. One more bathing suit will tie the score. Richard?
Present. Waiter.
Bathing suit is what we're after.
Oh, yes. Well, in England, we call them swimsuits.
Swimsuits. Tie score. One more swimsuit or bathing suit or bikini or string or whatever they call them these days will win the game for Paula Miller, and that'll be her third win.
Jeez, Paula, it's all up to me, huh?
I said a bathing suit.
There it is.
Congratulations.
All right, you know where to stand right there. Now, Susan, it was a pleasure to meet you, my dear.
It was fun. I really enjoyed it.
I'm glad you had a good time, and we'll have some gifts for you together with our thanks.
Thank
Susan
you.
McIntosh, ladies and gentlemen. While we're spinning her off, we're going to spin these messages just for you. And here they are. What are they, pal? Here she is for the third time, Paula Miller. Now, she's got $6,050, 6050. Let's see how you do now, Paula, with this one. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. A la blank. Now, the answer, remember, they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Then if you give us the second most frequently given response, you get $250. And if you team up with that third one, that gets you $100. Let's see what kind of help you'll get here.
Richard, please.
A la carte.
A la carte is one.
Brett.
A la mode.
A la mode.
Charles.
He's writing his novel.
I knew that.
Oh, you knew that. Go ahead then.
King.
A la king. A la king, a la carte, a la mode. Yaratarapadarapo. What do you say?
A la mode.
Okay, that's one bet gave you, right? A la mode. Let's find out if it a la mode is up there. May we see the $100 number? A la king.
Off to a good start.
A la king. I knew him well. A la mode. Are you under the $250 number? A la mode. Congratulations up to $6,300.
A la carte.
Now let's see. Which one did you applaud loudest for? A la mode. A la carte. And now a la carte, now that we've eliminated those other two. Figures how smart, huh? Okay, Earl, slide it.
A la carte.
All right. A la carte. I'm probably going to play for, remember, 10 times that amount or 2,500. Whom do you call up?
Richard, please.
You're in a rut. But you've done very well with him. You got good ESP with old Dawson over there. All right, old Dawson, ready?
Ready.
The Artful Dodger will now write. Blank tax. T-A-X. Well, Paula, he made up his mind very quickly, and now let's see what kind of answer you'll give us, which will match his. If it does, and if your ESP is going, it's been pretty good now. Tell us what it is. Blank tax.
Income tax.
Income tax. Okay. Yes. Avery says it's the first time income tax has ever gotten a hand, and I agree with that. Now, Richard, she says that's going to match it for $2,500.
Yeah, I'm sorry. What do you pay every time you buy something?
Sales tax.
Out of your income.
Out of your income. Very good. You got $8,800.
I can't believe it.
$8,800 for this little lady. And now she's still a champ. Going to meet another player. Let's welcome Sherry Sato. Hello, Sherry. You know Paula Miller.
Yes, I sure do, and congratulations.
You're Sherry Sato.
You are the first one who has pronounced it right.
And
it's,
you know,
Sato.
Sato.
Yes.
Well, Diane Janiver usually says, look at these names, because some of them you may, and today I didn't look at yours, and I just said it correctly.
You usually say Sato, and that's wrong.
Oh, really?
Wrong.
Yes.
Sato.
It was the Marquis de Sato, wasn't it?
It was.
Yes, it was.
Oh,
where are you from,
know how to
Sherry?
A girl
I'm
a
from
good
Carlsbad,
time.
California.
Where, California?
Carlsbad.
Carlsbad. I thought that was in New Mexico. When did they move it?
Carlsbad. Well, you know where La Costa is?
Yes.
Well, that's Carlsbad.
Oh, yes.
Down there by Camp Pendleton.
Right.
I have two beautiful kids, Jennifer, almost four, and Christopher, 2.5.
Mm-hmm.
My husband's there in the front row.
What does he do for a living?
He works for a sporting goods store.
How'd you meet him?
He was my next-door neighbor.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, I don't think I want to inquire any more about that. But...
You don't have to.
Okay. All right, Sherry, I won't. You ready to begin?
Yes, I think.
Okay. You may have A or B.
Would you like to push the button?
Oh, yes, of course.
You talk.
Oh.
See, it's a little test we give them. To see if they're alert and got all their wits about them.
We're nervous enough.
You're not nervous.
No.
Come on, we're all nervous, aren't we, folks?
Yeah.
Oh, we're so nervous up here. Unbelievable. What do you want then?
B, please.
B. Okay. B it is. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Hey, did you hear that Ugly Edna won first prize in a beauty contest?
No.
Yes, indeed. She won because the judges were blank. See how nervous Charles is?
If we could just get him awake, we'd be so thrilled.
You and me for you, isn't it? Right.
How you doing, my dear?
Not badly.
Yes,
how are
good.
You?
Now, what is this patch? See, that's very
interesting. It says Ralph Lauren.
Ralph Lauren.
Yes.
Oh, he's the did, yes. Did he do this one?
Yes.
Yes.
Not
very
personally,
chic.
Personally, I don't think.
Right. Okay, Charles.
You never know.
Charles, your time is up. All right. Did you hear that Ugly Edna won first prize in a beauty contest? She won because the judges were blank.
Blind.
Blind is what she said. Hello, Avery.
King?
What?
Oh, yes. Blind.
Blind it is. That's one where we are. Yes.
Thinking of my own lack of ability in certain areas, naturally I wrote blind.
I see. Charles?
I chose drunk.
Drunk.
Thinking of his natural ability.
Yes. Well, those are two good responses, all those. Now, Nancy?
Having won a few myself for that reason. Yes. Blind.
Blind, yes. Three for her. Okay. Make it four, will you, Richard?
All right, but it's pronounced blonde.
Blonde. Blonde.
Not a lot of people say that correct.
Right, blonde.
Blonde. Yes. Monkey.
Yes, yeah.
Minky.
Mr. Hilo would say blonde,
what
right
he
there.
Talking
yeah.
Yes.
What?
Blonde. Blonde.
What? What
blonde.
Is it?
Blonde. Blonde.
Come on.
They were blind drunk.
Blonde.
Blind drunk.
We say blonde.
Four for her.
Ready for yours?
Don't write.
We're not. Got a little message first, and then we'll be ready for hers. Ah, gotcha. Hello there. Now, we're ready for second half round one. Ready? You're ready. Okay. Are you ready?
Sure.
Dr. Frankenstein said...
Antipasto.
With a little sauce on it.
How very true.
When my monster went to the dance...
Do I have to listen to this?
You listen to this,
and you'll
or
like
you'll
it.
Be in big trouble. I'll put something right in your heart.
Not a steak. A steak.
When my monster went to the dance, there was a terrible misunderstanding.
Oh.
His date asked him to twist, and he twisted her blank.
Oh, off. Dear, oh, dear.
Oh.
You're the cutest little imitation.
When my monster went to the dance, there was a terrible misunderstanding. His date asked him to twist, and he twisted her blank off.
Isn't that
sweet? By Jove. By Jove.
Oh, yes, twisted
your okay. Paula Miller. Dr. Frankenstein said, when my monster went to the dance, there was a terrible misunderstanding. His date asked him to twist, and he twisted her blank off.
Her neck.
Twisted her neck off. Neck it is.
Twisted her neck off.
Neck off.
Left her like that, you mean?
Yes.
Okay. Her head.
Head. Head is not a neck. What do you say?
He didn't mean no harm.
No,
he just didn't understand.
Didn't
so
understand.
So he twisted a pretty little neck off.
Twisted his neck off. One for her.
I said legs because it was a dance.
Because it was a leg, you said dance. Because you said dance, it was a leg. Okay. Terrible misunderstanding. Did ask her to twist, and he twisted her blank off, and she said neck.
I said her pretty little head.
Her head.
I'm wrong. Uh-huh. I'm wrong.
Her head. Wrong again.
Well, shoot.
You're going downhill. Oh, like,
I'm going with her.
And you got a sled.
Three heads there, no necks there.
Three heads.
So, there we are, end of round one, 4-1, in favor of Sherry. What do you want, A or B?
B, please.
B. Did you get your water?
Yes, but it's gone.
You want some more?
A little later, I guess.
Okay, give her some more water. Flash Gordon said, my real name is Melvin Gordon. They started calling me Flash when I showed up at the space station wearing nothing but a blank. Charles and Joyce are the only two who do this. Okay.
Perfect. I wish I was doing this question.
Thank you. All right, Sherry, you think about this now. Thank you, Sydney. Flash Gordon said my real name is Melvin Gordon. Not bad. He said, my real name is Melvin Gordon. They started calling me Flash when I showed up at the space station wearing nothing but a...
flashlight.
You'll be all right. Drink your water. Well...
up till now.
You've never watched... no, you haven't. Have you ever heard of the Fernwood Flasher?
Pardon me?
No, she's never heard of the Fernwood Flasher. What do you say, Charles?
He's gonna put flashlight. It was on raincoat.
Huh? You know what a flasher is? You know what a flasher is?
He'll flash for you and let you
know. No, okay.
Man who has nothing to hide.
I don't know what a flasher is. What is a flasher, Gene?
Come on, just show your card.
It's a raincoat.
Raincoat. There is a certain sick mentality who disrobe themselves and put on a raincoat, and they go up to people and say, ah, blah, 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 see, that's called a flasher. Anyway, Sherry, you're up to four, and you got a shot at it, but right now I got a shot at you with this message of interest. Okay. We've got to stop right now. You ready to quit? Just got into it. Well, time flies when you're having fun. Get these flashes around here and time just goes by like leaving? That. What are you doing? Yes, we're leaving. Are you all ready to go?
Yeah.
Want to go on? No, we better quit right now. Save some for the next time, okay? Join us next time for Match Game 76. I am Gene Raper. Goodbye.